ForeFlight recently began offering takeoff and landing performance information in their application. The app pulls information from current METARs at your departing and arriving airports, and it calculates your takeoff and landing speeds and distances based on the weight and fuel loading you add. ForeFlight's careful to advise us that the numbers come from the pilot operating handbook values, and we all know those tend to be a little optimistic. So the Air Safety Institute decided to run a small test with two common airplanes, a Beechcraft Bonanza and a Cessna 182, to find out just how accurate are these calculations that we can now so easily see in ForeFlight. First, a Cessna 182.
Richard, your ground roll should be 433 feet.
Okay, thanks.
I flew the 182, and based on the weight and fuel that I entered and the METAR information that ForeFlight calculated, we expected a takeoff distance of 433 feet. In reality, as you can see, the 182 leaves the runway at about 600 feet, roughly 30% beyond the 433 feet calculated in ForeFlight.
Mike Juliet, we're expecting a 587 foot ground roll on this one.
Alrighty.
For landing, ForeFlight calculated a stopping distance of 587 feet with maximum braking. Now, I don't come to a complete stop because I'm on an active runway and I don't want to put too much wear and tear on the airplane and the brakes, but you can tell I would have been able to stop with moderate braking at about 760 feet. Again, a roughly 30% difference from what the ForeFlight app calculated. Next up, Dave Hirschman in a 1989 Bonanza.
Here comes the takeoff roll, starting at the 1,000-foot marker, maximum effort.
ForeFlight calculated his ground roll at 912 feet.
Airspeed's alive. Here comes my rotation speed now.
The Bonanza finally takes off at about 1,220 feet. Again, a roughly 30% difference in what was calculated by ForeFlight. For landing, ForeFlight calculated a distance of 911 feet, and that's about what Dave achieved. Interesting that this was the only parameter where the actual performance met the ForeFlight calculation in either airplane. The clips in this video are representative of the average performance Dave and I saw in each airplane. We executed 4 takeoffs and 4 landings and saw very little variance between each pattern. We in ASI saw 2 takeaways from this video. Number 1, it reinforces our long-standing recommendation to add 50% to your performance calculations. While we saw roughly a 30% difference in the numbers in our test, remember that we had well-maintained airplanes on a near-perfect day and pilots who were proficient in both airplanes. So adding 50 just gives you a little added safety margin to the 30% that we saw in our test. The second takeaway is, this gives you a great reason to go fly. Take your ForeFlight application, go out in the airplane that you fly, and see how your performance in your technique in your airplane stacks up against the ForeFlight calculated numbers. Thanks to ForeFlight for making this critical performance data so easily available to pilots who sign up for their Performance Plus subscription.